Hey guys, it's just Grant here again. I'd like to welcome a lot of YouTube viewers. I didn't actually realise that we had actually people watch these videos that I make, so it's quite cool. But here we are on Lake Rotorua again, and today I'm going to do something a bit different. I'm going to actually show you our line, our rods and our line and our lure configuration. So, because it seems that there's some beginners that are quite interested, and not that we know everything, I can guarantee you that. Okay, as I said before, we're just on Lake Rotorua. We're heading out the entrance now from a little place called Otaramarae, which is where we launched the boat. Okay, I'm just about to start trolling, but I'll explain to you what we've got here. We've got a, I'm using a Shimano leeching reel, which are also designed for salmon. Also designed for salmon fishing, and obviously we're fishing for trout today on the lake, so we have the same sort of thing. Now what we have is, this is using copper. I mainly use copper wire because it's cheaper. Well, not really, but it doesn't really matter. But because it goes a lot deeper than lead line. The alternative is you can go into a shop and just buy a rod and a reel and everything all kitted out with lead line. You can also use lead line on the conventional, like a snapper reel, over the top reel. But you can't really use copper on that reel because of the actual circumference of the spool. You need quite a big round spool for the copper, as you can imagine. So what we've got there is we've got like 100 metres of backing in behind there. Oh, the light's not too good. 100 metres of backing and on the reel, right from the centre out, and then we've got 100 metres of copper, and then from there we go two colours of lead line, so that's another 20 metres of lead line, which you can see there because it's purple and something else. And then after that we go 15 metres of nylon and then a metre of fluorocarbon to our lure. And today we're using a flat toby. I'll show you that in a minute. I'm not sure if this will actually focus, but this is a black toby. It's a 7 gram one and it's just black and gold. And what we do is we put a little red tag on the bottom. You see a little red tag there, and also I'm using these little red hooks, which you can buy, which are really quite good, I think. And of course everybody has their own opinion, and somebody who knows a bit about trout fishing will say, oh, you don't use those bloody things, you use a bloody traffic light, or you use something else. So it's quite funny really, but this is what we use, and we have quite good success, and there's no complaints, so we catch some nice ones on these black tobies. So I'm just about to lead it out now, and I'll show you how that happens. So here we go. Alright, so what I'm doing here is I'm trolling along at about 2 knots, and trying to let it out one-handed is not that easy, actually, because I'm holding the camera with the other hand. But the concept is that you troll along, you can actually speed the boat up. It makes it easier to speed the boat up just to let it out. So, but just hang on a minute, the bloody thing's stuck. No, it's not going to work. Hang on. It's not easy doing this when you're trying to... Here we go. And then of course, I have potential, I have high potential for a mess here, so I'm not going to even bloody do it. So, but that's the concept, so you let it out. Now the reason for using copper is it goes down to about 18 metres deep, which is where all the big ones are. We don't want the little ones, we just want the big buggers. So, obviously you have to troll in maybe 20 metres or above. 20 metres or deeper, sorry. Otherwise you hit the bottom, logically. So, yep, that's the story there. So you need to know where to go, otherwise you have mayday situations. But in times to come, I'll make other videos and I'll show you what happens when you do go too shallow and how to fix it easy so you don't have a too big of balls up. Okay, so it's all looking pretty good. So I'm going to go and start catching fish now. So we'll catch you later. We'll see you next time. And thanks for subscribing. That's absolutely awesome. I didn't realise that people were actually... interested, so cool as. Anyway guys, we'll catch you later. Just one more thing, we actually use these little outriggers, which are made by a company called Berkeley, and what they do is it allows us to have the rod sticking horizontally out from the boat, and the reason for that is when we've got two rods, one on either side, when we turn a corner, we don't get into a big tangled mess. Because if the rods are too close together, sometimes when you turn a corner, one goes up, one stays a similar different height, and they go underneath each other and you end up in a hoover mess. So that's the idea of that. So it's a good idea to get them. They're not very dear and they save you a lot of hassle. Okay. And here's the first one for the day. It's looking really nice. It's a nice looking little fish. It's not going to win any prizes, but it's a good looking fish. Awesome. There they are, look. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just got to get the buggers to bite. So far I've got 3, so I'm doing all right. Not too bad. Yeah, they made it. Bloody wind's got us. So, I'll just have a look here. Yeah. So that's, look at them all, there's heaps of them on there, but they're quite low level, they're like 10, 12 metres. That big fat bugger there, that'll be a nice one to get, that's about 15 metres. But of course you see them on the sounder, and by the time the line gets to them, which is 100 metres behind the boat, of course they're long gone. You want the ones that sit down here on the bottom, because they're lazy buggers, and they just sit there, and then as you go over the top of them, as long as you straight line it, 9 times out of 10 you get them, but the ones that are up here are actually mobile, so the chance of getting them is quite rare, but it does happen sometimes. So, okay. Here are my surgery tools for getting into my trout. Hi guys. This is the end result of my fishing today. Got 3 nice ones, nice trout. So 2 of which will be, I'm just about to gut them and dehead them and fillet them, and I'm just going to put 2 in the vacuum seal to seal them up and put them in the freezer, and the other one I'll smoke. So, awesome.